Been hibernating in the deepest, darkest part of Necropolis. Now that I'm popping this top, yes, I'm the opposite of monogamous. Menage, get odd with it in this box. A bitch, hostile. It's gotta get twisted and odd with this apocalypse. Holla it.
Tech, night, bitch, I'm loving it.
I'm a drug to this grudge if it's ripped my covenant up rugged. Loving this mother, this is what the ruggus is. Psycho thug with it falling down like Michael Douglas with the ruggishness.
How did I mean? They wondering, what did I bring? That's out of my dream. The Nina's a horror machine. Dollar for dollar, a baller for all of my cream. My name is an Ego Montoya. I got an evil plan for ya. And you're about to get dropped. This box is worse than Pandora. They're gonna laugh at you, cause I had to do what I had to do and tap on you like Shabba do. Beating them up and shooting them up, then sick with you. Sad you knew that your hands are cool and they out the through. I'm killing them, throwing them back at you.
That's what's happening. Strange music box got us tapping in. Strange music box, funk that slap again. Strange music knock back up, open it.
Bringing a god, I'm making war. Caliban, check my strange box of tricks. Calico, alley cat, lyrical. Watch his lips, he can go really fast. Slow it down and stop that. I'll make it all to make sure you knew. Got that. I'm just playing with you.
Obi Trice, real name, no gimmicks.
I'm back with another video, my first durability review. So we all know the LeBron 11 came out in October of last year, and that was probably the best shoe of 2013. So let's see how the best performing shoe of the year stands to the test of time. Just a quick overview of the shoe's materials. It is the lightest LeBron shoe ever, weighing in at 14.5 ounces. The upper consists of hypercomposite panels for comfortable support, synthetic and mesh for a breathable and snug fit. We also have some fly wire, as we do in most of the Nike shoes today for lockdown. Rubber outsole with carbon fiber shank, and Lunar Lawn and full-length Zoom mix for the cushion setup. The hypercomposite wing is held up as well as you probably would expect them to. Not very well at all. Just think about it. The panels are hard foam with paint on them and a protective layer. A couple of games in, there were blue paint marks and black scratches that I could not get off. And then after a couple months, the paint and the foam started to wear away. So then it came this ugly sort of gray color. And that just took away from the aesthetics part of it, but they still got the job done performance wise. I noticed in the forefoot, right where the toe bends, there was some serious cracking and just splitting of the material up front. So that was a big problem in terms of aesthetics. So the LeBron 11 is a two-piece upper, so they're two different parts glued together cheaply, so only lateral movements gonna come apart. See, they fixed this on the LeBron 12 by making it really a one-piece upper, but on LeBron 11, the high-quality materials, which is a good thing, were glued together, bad thing. So they would come apart right where they would meet, and that would cause, for not pain, but it really took away from the stability on different cuts. You would feel your foot sliding inside the shoe. The shoe collar durability was good. I mean, for you guys who wear the ankle braces, it wasn't good. The in-shoe materials would latch on to the Velcro, and it would rip off to the point where you could see, like, I think it was cardboard or something inside the shoe. So when you didn't wear braces, they would just dig into your ankle on a bunch of lateral movements, and that would cause for a lot of pain. Overall, aesthetically, the shoe still looked good, looked great from the distance, and still looked pretty nice up close. The lacing system on this shoe was crazy. They had thick laces combined with a thick mesh tongue, which combined with fly wire definitely made this one of the best lacing systems I've had out of the four shoes that I own. The tighter you pulled the laces, the better they felt. Unlike the other shoes, they didn't dig into your foot because of the tongue was too thin, or because the laces were too thin. They were both thick, and they felt really comfortable, and it felt like a sock every time you put the shoe on. Because you could pull them tighter, the fly wire worked better. Durability-wise, the lacing system was great. I mean, the cushion had its ups and downs. It got better as time went on. It molded to your foot very well. However, probably about 5 months in, the shoe started to squeak loudly every time you took a step. You literally sounded like SpongeBob walking down the street. I'm not messing with you. Now, this wasn't technically a performance issue. However, it did stop me from playing in them for long periods of time. So I'll say that it was an audible aesthetic problem. The traction was probably the worst thing about the shoe. After 2 months with strictly indoor play, it started to wear so much to the point where it got smooth. And that was a big problem. And then after some outdoor wear, not that much, like probably like an hour every week outdoor wear, it started to wear all the way through to where you could see the plastic on the inside of the shoe. So when you played in serious games, you would fall over because you had no traction. And that was sort of the killer thing about this shoe. Overall, the LeBron shoe is not a hoopable shoe after 1 year, mainly because of the traction, how it held up so badly. Other than that, it's still a good casual shoe if you do not mind sounding like SpongeBob every time you walk.